Previously we talked of the mechanism of the implantation. Now we know implantation will lead to pregnancy. Right? So implantation will lead to pregnancy, and later on the pregnancy development starts. That is, the various organs and organ system starts. So after this implantation reaction, the finger-like projections, which are called as chorionic villi, is surrounded by the uterine tissue as well as metal endothel. This we have seen during implantation mechanism only. Now, later on, this chorionic villi is forming a gap. It is forming a connection, a structural and functional unit between the two structures. That is, between the fetus as well as maternal blood. And the structure is what we call it as placenta. Again, I am repeating. After implantation, this finger-like projections arises from the trophoblast layer cells or the trophoblast cells of the blastocyst. Through the endometrium layer, it reaches up to the maternal blood. After this, it forms a structural and functional unit, and that is what we call it as placenta. This structure and function is formed between fetus as well as maternal blood. What are the various functions of the placenta? Again, it is acting as a passage for the transport of the respiratory gases like oxygen, transport of the nutrients or the nutritive nourishment material, removal of the waste, that is carbon dioxide, by metabolic reaction that is produced. Removal of excretory waste is also an important role of placenta only. Apart from this, placenta also acts as an endocrine gland or endocrine tissue. Secretes two important hormones. The first one is HCG, that is human chorionic gonadotropin, and HPL, human placental lactogen. So HCG, that is human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, is also called as pregnancy hormone. Now HCG and HPL is human placental lactogen. Now HCG hormone, the concentration of HCG hormone increases in blood and urine during pregnancy period. And in order to confirm whether the female is pregnant or not, this hormone is tested in the urine, and the test is called as Grevindex test. The test is called as Grevindex test. Basically, it is nothing, a kit test that is readily available in the market. In the urine, what they check is whether HCG is present or not. And on the kit, the antibody against HCG is coated, and HCG is treated as an antigen. If antigen is there, antibody is also available, then antigen-antibody elimination reaction takes place, some color is visualized, that's it. Test name you will remember, that is called as Grevindex test. So this is human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, HCG. Then human placental lactogen. This is one of the most important hormones that is also secreted during the pregnancy period. And who secretes? Placenta. The role of human placental lactogen is it stimulates mammary glands to secrete milk. So HPL stimulates mammary gland. Stimulates mammary glands for milk production. Because ultimately fertilization has taken place, implantation also taken place, now parturition will take place. That's it. And once the baby is delivered out from the mother's womb, the baby needs milk, and milk production job is by mammary glands. During the later stages of the pregnancy, that means when it is nearby about the end of the pregnancy period or the gestation period, one important hormone is secreted by the ovary, that is what we call it as relaxin, which relaxes the wall of the cervix. So during the end of gestation period, relaxin is secreted by the ovary. What this relaxin is going to do? It's relaxes the cervical wall for easy expulsion of baby from the cervix. Right? So it relaxes. Function is, it relaxes the cervical wall, or you can also write relaxes the cervix for easy expulsion of fully grown or fully developed fetus from the mother body. It relaxes the cervical wall, or you can also write cervix for easy expulsion, that is removal of fully grown developed fetus from the body of the mother. Right? Then next thing that we need to remember is HCG, HPL and this relaxin hormone. These three hormones are secreted only and only during pregnancy period. That's it. Human chorionic gonadotrophin, HCG, human placental lactogen, HPL, which stimulates the mammary gland for milk production, relaxin secreted by the ovary, relaxes the cervical wall of the cervix for easy expulsion of the fully grown or the developed fetus from the mother's body. These three hormones, HCG, HPL and relaxin, are secreted in the female body only and only during pregnancy period. Right? Now there are other hormones like estrogen, progesterone, prolactin, cortisol, prolactin, cortisol, thyroxin, they remain increased in the maternal blood. So they remain increased. The concentration increases throughout in the maternal blood for the development of the fetus. Right? For fetal growth, and its gestation mechanism.